Today we're going to be talking about some artwork that will get you massively reported until you either leave the internet or all of your social medias are taken down and you are never able to return to creating art online again. You might be thinking to yourself, dang bro, is that even possible? That seems kind of harsh. Unfortunately, that's the case with this particular artist and drawing artwork of this persona that represents a YouTuber. This happens to be pretty topical right now in my sphere of the internet because we just discussed Jaden Animations and how she handled artwork of her persona being looted or not safe for work art made of her character that represents her online. Jaden was very chill about the situation. She said that she understands that this is something that she can't really do much about and that it's something that doesn't genuinely bother her, but she would like for it to be put into sort of like a boundary or respected in a situation where people try to keep this type of artwork within their communities only so that people of all ages aren't able to reach this type of artwork. Now, the YouTuber we're going to be talking about today has been very well known for not handling situations as gracefully as Jaden Animations ever. To put it lightly, I don't think for one moment in their career have they ever handled something that they dislike in a graceful manner. We'll be talking about iilluminaughtii today, who is a YouTuber that I didn't really know much about until I started researching more about them myself. And I got a little help from another commentary channel, Tipster, who you may or may not know, which we will hear from later in this video. iilluminaughtii is a YouTuber that is about to hit 1 million subscribers. They discuss pyramid schemes, scams, problems within corporations, scummy CEOs, things of that nature. I definitely think what they do on their channel is great. I like what they are able to accomplish, and I love the information that they're able to provide to people. But what I do not like is how easily iilluminaughtii will weaponize her audience and fandom against individuals that she does not like. Now, the person that I mentioned earlier that will be helping me out with this video is Tipster. They have a great hour-long video on iilluminaughtii, which if you do have time, I highly suggest you check that video out if you want to know more about the scandals this person has been involved in. But I can do a little bit of a summary the quickest way I can possible. Like I mentioned earlier, iilluminaughtii is in this kind of pyramid scheme, scam, talking about scummy CEOs, niche section of the internet when it comes to commentary on YouTube. This is a community, so there are other channels that discuss this topic as well. Another content creator within this community is known as Cruel World Happy Mind, and they were told by viewers that they thought that iilluminaughtii had sort of copied Cruel World's video at one point in time. Cruel World decided to DM iilluminaughtii discussing this and wanting to kind of make a dialogue about it and find out what was going on because they weren't sure if this just was coincidental or not. What happened was iilluminaughtii decided to go on to a podcast and slander this person and tell people in her fandom that they were not trustworthy and that people should not follow Cruel World because of their bizarre take on iilluminaughtii's video. From my perspective, Cruel World's take on iilluminaughtii's video was in no way bizarre. She was just trying to clear up whether something was coincidental or not. And the way that iilluminaughtii behaved and reacted is a way that she reacts pretty consistently. It is a pattern of behavior where she will target, harass, slander, and issue her audience to be weaponized against individuals she does not like. iilluminaughtii has also been known to reach out to her fandom in order to get them to DMCA or copyright strike creators that she has a problem with. For example, the commentary channel Nicholas DeOrio made a meme video about iilluminaughtii, poking fun at her in this video, so obviously iilluminaughtii was going to have a problem with that. Featured in the thumbnail was artwork of iilluminaughtii's persona. iilluminaughtii decided to get in contact with the artist that created this artwork that was featured in Nicholas DeOrio's thumbnail and pushed that artist to issue copyright strikes against Nicholas so that their video was taken down. Fortunately, iilluminaughtii's plans failed. Nicholas was able to keep that video up by discussing things with the artist themselves. They decided to change that thumbnail in order to have the artist remove the strike that they had issued on their channel. Tipster happened to be involved in this particular incident, so I'm going to allow them to tell their side of the story and exactly what happened with Illuminati.
So thanks for having me on, man. I guess you want me to tell my story about my run-in with Illuminati, and I'll do the best I can based off of my memory. It was quite some time ago, but I guess the best place to start is to kind of set up the stage for like what was going on at the time, as this situation involved the YouTuber known as Tommy C. It's important to understand that at that moment in time, Tommy C and I weren't getting along. We had a bit of a misunderstanding over some Twitter exchanges and stuff like that, so we weren't exactly on the best footing with each other. We weren't exactly getting along and stuff like that. So that kind of sets the stage for like what happened in this particular situation, especially since someone else that this involves, known as Nicholas DiOrio, you know, was and still is good friends with Tommy C. So understandably, you know, any disagreements me and Tommy had, Nick would definitely go to bat for them. So needless to say, me and Nick didn't get along at the time very well either. Anyway, fast forward to apparently there was some sort of falling out between Tommy C, Nicholas DiOrio, and Illuminati. So Nick decided to do a video on his channel, I believe it was his second channel, not his main channel, talking about the issues that he had with Illuminati. And shortly after that video went public, apparently it got taken down via a copyright strike, and there was a lot of confusion in the community as to exactly what happened. Obviously, a lot of people were speculating that, hey, maybe Illuminati was somehow behind the strike. Granted, it didn't say Illuminati's name on it. It said some Twitter artist's name on it. And so, understandably, Nick tried to reach out to this artist and they came to some kind of agreement. Apparently, the artist said they struck it because they got upset that some of their artwork was used in the thumbnail for the video. So Nick said, hey, if you remove the strike, I'll change the thumbnail. And my understanding is they did exactly that. The strike was removed and the thumbnail was changed. But a lot of people still thought it was really weird. Like, why did this artist like come out of nowhere and strike down this video? And they suspected that Illuminati had something to do with it. And I remember Tommy C was doing a live stream where they were discussing this whole situation, they're falling out, the strike and everything. And it just so happened that while that live stream was broadcasting, Illuminati of all people reached out to me via Twitter DMs and literally confessed to me that they were behind the strike. Now, I know it's a little bit confusing because you're like, hey, you said the artist struck the video. How was Illuminati behind the strike? Well, essentially, she slid into my DMs to give me screenshot proof that she reached out to the artist herself and basically said, hey, this guy's using your art for a hate video against me. You might want to protect your art. Literally kind of suggesting that this artist issue this copyright strike against, you know, Nick's video. And keep in mind, like, the way that he used the art, you know, in my view, it qualified as fair use. But I know a lot of Twitter artists, they get really confused how, like, you know, fair use pertains to art and stuff like that. It's a constant debate within the community. But in any case, she basically confessed to me in DMs that she was responsible for this artist issuing this strike. And I don't know why she did that. My only assumption, the reason why I kind of clarified before that me and Tommy weren't getting along, my only assumption as to why she would have done this is because she knew that me and Tommy weren't getting along at the time. So maybe she thought I would have a good laugh at it. Oh, haha, you know, me and Nick and Tommy, we all don't like each other right now. So let's have a laugh at the fact that she got a copyright strike on Nick's channel. But anybody who knows anything against me, or about me rather, knows that I am not a big fan of copyright strikes or false, you know, flagging campaigns and stuff like that. I'm not a big fan of that stuff. So if you're going to slide into my DMs bragging about issuing a false copyright strike against someone, like, that's a huge mistake. Not to mention the fact that I'm essentially like a drama news channel, right? And you're basically sliding into my DMs to admit you did something that's really frowned upon in the community. I don't know what her endgame was for that, but I'm willing to bet it didn't work out the way she thought it was going to work out. And considering, like, in conjunction, when you take all the things that she's done before in combination with, like, this situation that I was involved in, you know, falsely accusing people of subbotting and, you know, strong-arming smaller creators to try and silence them and stuff like that, it just shows a pattern of behavior with Illuminati, and it just one of those things, like, it still boggles my mind to this day. Why did she slide into my DMs to admit that she was involved in someone having a false copyright strike issued on their channel? It's the dumbest thing that I've ever seen. You literally can't make this stuff up, but alas, it's something she did, and it's something that I still laugh about to this day.
I'm extremely grateful to have Tipster give us a little bit more insight into this commentary community. He has a ton of experience with a lot of these commentary channels and a lot of experience with Illuminati. Some of those experiences with Illuminati being not so great if you look at it from an outsider perspective. Tipster runs their own commentary channel and has a blog and website as well. On that blog, they've talked about their mental health battles and how being a YouTuber has provided an outlet to help them with their mental health struggles. Illuminati decided to mock those mental health struggles Tipster was dealing with and read that blog post in a very belittling and sarcastic manner on a video or podcast. That's all the backstory that we need. Illuminati has a repeated pattern of this behavior. Now we're going to get into the artist that was obliterated off of the internet by Illuminati's fandom for creating lewd artwork of her persona, this pyramid character. Now, for the most part, I can understand Illuminati's perspective here with not wanting this character to be looted or to have not safe for work art created of her persona. She has made it very clear publicly that she does not want this type of artwork created of this pyramid character. And I completely understand that and would hope that people would respect that and would understand those boundaries. What I think is a little egotistical, though, is that she thinks that everyone that is an artist would know that that's her wish, would know that she doesn't want that artwork made of her character. The artist we're going to be talking about today is Lewden Waffle, who has not been on the internet since their altercation with Illuminati. Based on the information that I've gotten, Lewden Waffle held a poll and people voted to have Illuminati's persona as the next character for them to draw. Lewden Waffle drew Illuminati's Pyramid Girl in a one-piece bathing suit. This was enough to trigger Illuminati into saying that they were gross and disgusting as an artist, that they went against their wishes to not have their character drawn in a lewd way. This drawing of the Pyramid Girl in a one-piece bathing suit was enough to get Illuminati so pissed off that she weaponized her audience against Lewden Waffles, encouraging her audience to go massively report this person's account on Twitter until either they removed their account or Twitter removed their account for them. The harassment Lewden Waffles dealt with was so bad that I still do not see a snippet of them online whatsoever. It has been months since this incident occurred, and Lewden Waffles has yet to return as an artist online. I've even seen recent tweets where people are asking if Lewden Waffles has another at, or if they moved to another website, or what happened to them, you know, in any kind of capacity. People just do not know. The person vanished from the internet, and it's because of the harassment that Illuminati encouraged her fans to do. Now, don't get me wrong, I can totally understand Illuminati wanting somebody to respect boundaries and respect their wishes when it comes to not looting their persona. But I do not understand or respect Illuminati for doing a smear campaign against this artist and encouraging their fans to massively report this person for just making art that isn't even that lewd. If you look at some of the other artwork that she's featured on her channel, she features an artist that made artwork of Illuminati's persona in a bikini, which is almost exactly the same as what Lewden Waffles had drawn. It just goes to show that she likes to pick and choose who she allows to do what in her communities. And if she doesn't like you, she will weaponize her audience against you in order to try and take you down. If you follow my channel whatsoever, I think you'll be able to see which road is painfully obvious, the right road to choose. Either deal with things the way Jaden Animations dealt with them, or deal with things the way Illuminati decided to deal with them. Again, I don't think that Illuminati's channel's bad. I don't think the content she makes is bad. I think it's great. And I just don't appreciate anybody that decides to weaponize their audience against people that they don't like. If you know my history on this channel, you have definitely seen me deal with that myself. And I know as a smaller content creator or artist, that type of harassment can be really trying and really painful to deal with. And oftentimes, people don't make it through that type of stuff, like with what we saw with Lewden Waffles. I'd love to hear everybody's opinions on this in the comments section. I'll see y'all down there. Everybody take care. Later.